Tinker. It's Nene. And today we're going to be talking about...
One.
Oh, hey, Mr. One.
One.
Oh. Zero.
Oh, hi. Hi, Mr.
Zero.
Zero.
Oh,
it's so
zero.
Good to
one.
Be
zero. One.
More ones.
Zero.
One.
Zero.
One.
We are
zero.
Number one.
Zero.
Zero.
Whoa.
We are number one.
Dude, just one. Kidding. One. Zeros. Calm down. It's getting
one.
Crowded in here.
Zero.
Zeros. That's it. Tinkers. It's coding day. Come on.
It's Tinkertime.
That's right, Tinkerers. Today is coding day, and we are going to be playing with coding in a new and interesting way. So we might think that computers are the cleverest machines in the world, and they're going to take us over. But in some ways they're clever, and in other ways they're just really good at following incredibly specific instructions like code. So today we're going to be playing with a binary code. Now, binary code is basically made up of ones.
One.
And zeros.
Zero.
That's right. Everything is ones and zeros. And today we're going to be using the uppercase, the capital letter alphabet, to be making our names. So here what I've made is a special secret code. Ooh. N-A-Y-N-A-Y. Nay, nay. So let's learn how to make those amazing coding necklaces. So here is our binary code graph that shows us each capital letter of the alphabet and the ones and zeros that make up that letter. So we need to find N for nay, nay. And it's just down here. Now the letter N is made up of 100, 1110. And then I'm looking to A, and then to Y. So what I'm going to do, Tinkerers, is I'm going to put these sheets up on my website so you can print them or download them and make your own coding necklace. Let's get started. For Nene, N-A-Y. Now, because Nene is repeatable, today I'm just going to do the three letters in my coding sheet. Find the N. And we copy down 100110. Seven numbers to make up the one letter. A, 100001. And last letter for nay is Y. 101, 1001. So what I need is a different bead to represent the ones and a different bead to represent the zeros. Today, representing the ones, we have the pink bead. Ooh, a marvelous choice for representing the ones. And today, representing the zeros, we have the brown beads. Ooh, very mysterious. Pink for our ones and brown for our zeros. Now the only other bead I'm going to need is to separate each letter because we really don't want it to get confusing. I want people to see my necklace and know exactly what my name is. So today I think I might use this purple bead as a space. So here we have our piece of elastic and I'm going to start threading on our code. So I look at my sheet, pink representing the ones, so we won. Now we have two brown beads for the zeros. And here we go. 1001. Now, of course, you can use any beads that you want, any colors that you want. Our first letter. That's the letter N right there. So now to separate with a space, I'm going to use that purple bead that I talked about. So I thread him on like that. One, two pink beads. Another brown bead for the ones. Here we go. Now, if you don't have beads at home, another really fun way of using beads is by collecting gum nuts and putting holes in them. Or the other thing you could do is use different pieces of pasta. Zero. Zero. There we have. 10000001. And there we have it. N-A-Y-N-A-Y. So now that's a really simple and interesting coding necklace. Secret Society style. I like it.
It's Tinkertime.
Looking stylin'.
Next week on Tinkertime.
And there's one screw that just doesn't fit any of my screwdriver heads. So I've made a decision. We're gonna smash it open!